Thank you so much for coming to the show. I know this is rare. You wouldn't usually come to the studio, but we appreciate it given the circumstances. All right, the accusations are very serious. Number one, extortion.
Yeah.
Corruption.
Yeah. Bribery.
Bribery. He claims that because they were unable to grant all your requests of appointments, that you then had turned against them. Words, hawa kami sa liig. You have an emissary in Congress that's been messaging. Okay, first of all, do you know a congresswoman? Do you have an emissary?
I have many congresswoman friends. So I dare him to name her. I dare him to name her in an impeachment complaint because that is the proper venue. Instead of lying to the public and trying to get sympathy, is distracting us from the issue that he is disqualified to sit as representative, as congressman of a youth sector. He can cry all he wants. He can even accuse me of murder. But will the people believe him? The facts will show that I objected to Cardemo's substitution on May 12, replacing his wife because he was disqualified. I said the wife should sit because she was 29 years old and the limit is 30. So that's not a secret that as early as May 12, I already objected to his substitution. And then to his malas, his bad luck, it was raffled to my division. And then to his malas again, it was the presiding commissioner went on leave and I became acting presiding commissioner of the division. So now, instead of one vote, we got two votes because the other commissioners from Davao studied it well and decided after the hearing that he is disqualified. He is overage. So now, to get back at me, he will say all these things. If he had any transaction with that congresswoman, he should just name her because now he admits that he committed attempted bribery against a Comelec commissioner.
Okay, first, let's talk about his accusations first, then the issue regarding Cardema himself as a nominee first. Why would he lie? He says he has text messages of us coming from a specific congresswoman. Could it be possible that you do have a congresswoman friend that was acting on your behalf that you may not be aware of?
Now, anything is possible in this country. You know, politicians say anything in their favor. But I don't have anybody who is like my de facto alter ego. Nobody can say that I represent Bing Guanzo, Commissioner Guanzo. None of my classmates even appear or accept cases in the Comelec because I'm very strict. Now, I think he made up those texts, but if he did not, it shows, I think, January, he was NYC commissioner. So what is he doing attempting to bribe a commissioner when he was the chair of a government office of the president? That is why the presidential spokesperson said, do not drag the palace in your fight against Guanzon. Because it's obvious, even to Malacanang, that this guy is just attracting attention because he's already bankrupt. He's not gonna get this job. He will not be congressman. He kicked out his wife, so she will not be congresswoman. He has no job now. His wife has no job now. How is he going to eat? So he makes all this hype to attract everybody's attention. I say this to his funders because I know he doesn't have money on his own. You stop giving this guy money. And I say this to the youth sector who voted for Duterte Youth. Sayang lang your votes. Another party list based in Davao, like Marino, could have gotten three seats. Instead of this guy, he just fooled you. He could have gotten a real representative. He fooled you. Ginawa niya kayong tanga. Pero siya talaga ang tanga.
Okay, now he also claimed in his interview with Christian Izguera that the Comelec has also approved five nominees above the age of 40.
No, we did not approve.
Okay, can you?
That's the point of my dissenting opinion.
Yes. He says he is not the only one. There's one that was 28. The others are all above 40 years old.
No.
Why single him out?
No. In the substituted list where he kicked out his wife, there are five of them there. Okay, four of them are over 40, which is really why I objected. Why accept their substitution? And then the fifth one is not qualified because she was not a member of their party list for at least 90 days. Sumunod naman kayo sa batas, you follow the law. Instead of pressuring us to twist the law in your favor. I mean, what do you think about stupid? I mean, we're not stupid. You are stupid.
He also told Christian that they are registered not just as a youth group, but as a youth and professional group, which allows...
We already did this in the hearing, and it's in our resolution. You should publish that resolution. It's beautifully written by a Congress, a commissioner from Davao. And it says there, all the time, all their papers will show they registered as a youth sector. Why are they now saying they're young professionals and he's not even a professional because he was kicked out of a government college? Why are they saying it now as an afterthought because they're overage? When you say you are a young professional, you should have attached your list for young professionals. You should have attached your list for your youth sector. Now, under the law, it is the same, and the Supreme Court has ruled on this in Hamoret versus HRET, that if you are a multisectoral party, and Senator Joel Villanueva was the one who was disqualified because of this case, if you attach to a youth sector, even if you say you are multisectoral, youth sector, gay sector, young professionals, you still have to comply with the 25 to 30 year old limit because you already have youth sector there.
Yeah, so there's a precedent.
So if they are young professionals, they should also not be over 30, correct? You should, I will publish that resolution in a broadsheet so that people will understand.
All right, for the record, are you the only one who truly dissented based on his arguments that lahat pumayag puwera si Bing Guanzon? Ginagawa niyang parang tanga, she's making all the other commissioners look stupid. That was the essence of the interview. Because the reason I'm asking this is, if it is so clear what is right and what it says under the law, why isn't it unanimous?
It is unanimous in the first division.
Yes, that's the first.
Nobody objected out of three. You see, he's stupid. He doesn't understand the rules. No big lawyer, big name lawyer will take his case because it's very hard to drill into his head that there are rules of court in the COMELEC. Even when we accept your substitution and somebody objects to your qualifications, you have to have a hearing. And that's what Sixto Brillantes et al. Did, representing the College Editors Guild. That's why he was disqualified eventually. In a unanimous decision by the division.
So yung what he claimed, alam nyo, in January 2016, the COMELEC called us, tumawag ang COMELEC at said, the four commissioners approved Duterte Youth already. Tapos a congresswoman called and told me, kailangan ng signature ni Bing. So eto ang inilalabi, judge in Iloilo, appointment, regional director. So etong alleged four commissioners, was there at any point the possibility of four commissioners approving?
Now, he should name the one who called him. Huh? So I will know. Huh? If it's an employee of the COMELEC, I will not stop until you are removed. Reminder, I had criminal cases filed against that election officer in Muntinlupa who faked our voters list. He was issued a warrant.
This is quite interesting because he refuses to name the emissary. Yeah. He refuses to name the employee at the COMELEC.
And are you supposed to believe this? He's been given a lot of time by the media, you know. But he shoots himself in his head, no? And then he threatens us that he will... I saw that text. Yeah. It says there, magpakamatay na lang ako, I will just die by suicide in front of COMELEC. Well, go ahead. Make my day.
But he said he's willing to have his phone examined.
Well, go ahead. That's your problem. That's your phone. You can go ahead and... But he has to spend money, huh? How come the media keeps on covering him with all this stupidity? Huh? It's very obvious that he is already lying, and yet the media keeps on.
So why do you think, I want to ask you, if you believe, okay, he's lying, there's no basis, he's faking everything, where would he get this energy, frankly? It's a bit tiring to watch people make up stories if they're absolutely untrue.
Because there's something wrong with his head.
So you think psychologically he's ill?
He should already be seen by a psychiatrist. He says his wife is in the hospital, his father's in the hospital. This guy's breaking down. I mean, his friends should tell him, take your meds.
So you think, you feel now it's already mental breakdown?
Yeah, this is already a nervous breakdown. You look at this guy. I mean, you look at this, the way he carries himself. He thinks he's some kind of leader of the Hitler Youth or something. That's his persona. But he's so duwag, huh? He's a coward. He will not even name the congresswoman. He will not name the COMELEC official who called him. Mm-mm. What does he think of himself?
He also claims that no less than someone from the law department of COMELEC asked him na isingit ang name niya ulit when they submitted a new list of nominees for the motion for reconsideration.
Okay, I will have that placed in the agenda for next week, huh? I will investigate everybody in the law department, huh? But if they really did this, I'm gonna get your head, and you know it. Now. That's the trouble.
Yeah, go.
He makes up stories and then he'll make dumb my other people. Yeah, that's unfair. Mm-mm. Now, he filed an appeal. It is now with the en banc. So he gets to win if he gets 4 votes, right? But we're already 3. So he has to get a perfect score, which is very hard to do, right? It's very hard to reverse a decision of a division unless you pay the consideration. Yeah? So it is like this. He appealed, but he submitted another list. And it's still him as number one nominee. And his wife said, how many times does he have to be told that he's overage, he's disqualified? Which part of the queue doesn't he understand? Yeah. I mean, this is already...
Mm-mm. Yeah.
This is really getting to be obvious that there's something wrong with his head.
You know, he was asked, Christian asked him, okay, why not just remove your name? And then because the party list had already won, why not remove your name and replace it with another nominee that fits under 30 or until 30 during election day?
Well, what did he say?
And he said, wala na kaming pakialam kung mawala ang seat namin sa Kongreso. Oh. Hawak kami ni Guanzon sa leeg since January at hanggang ngayon. Pinalalabas niya, malinis siya, etc. So it became about you. My first legal question, can they actually lose a seat? They won, but if this is not settled, can they lose their seat?
If they don't win the appeal, they don't get a seat. Mm-mm. They don't lose it because they never had it. They don't get a seat. Mm-mm. You cannot force the Commission on Elections to give you a seat, even if you fooled 170,000 young people to vote for you. Mm-mm.
So in other words, that's what you're saying, and this is already in terms of the future of the Duterte Youth Party list. Even if they had 170,000 votes, if this is not settled, there is no seat.
If he doesn't win the appeal. Mm-mm.
But what if he doesn't win, but then there are other nominees that are below 30? Can they be moved as first nominee, or it doesn't work that way?
I don't want to preempt the commission and bank. It doesn't work that way. Because he already substituted on May 12. What do you want to do, substitute again? How's that? How is it that there's no deadline for party list and the congressmen and congresswomen have to be, they can only be substituted at a certain time? Yeah. And in case of death, incapacity, choo-choo.
Yeah,
this guy, whatever he does, he will never be congressman or representative of a youth sector because he's already dog youth.
Ang tanong niya, why was he even allowed to register? I mean, in effect, ang argument niya is they won. The COMELEC knew he was already the nominee.
Overage.
But pumayag.
I was the one who pointed it out that he was overage.
So you're saying from the very beginning...
His wife was qualified. How many times do I have to say, stupid, that your wife was qualified, but you kicked her out because you're greedy? That's the trouble with people like you. You don't follow the law. Now your wife is going crazy also because you are poor, you have no job. Where will you get money for your... I'm sorry for your wife, really. But she should be sitting okay. Congresswoman so, now, if not for you, Cardamac.
So wait, are you saying that the COMELEC had no lapses from the very beginning?
We just accept.
Okay.
They file, that's why I told the law department to investigate him for material misrepresentation.
Okay, let's talk about that.
Why? Because he submitted a certificate of nomination saying that he is not disqualified. All four of them will face material misrepresentation as an election offense. Because they, under oath, they said they are not overage. They are qualified. Oh, you mean you can just fool the COMELEC? And when we stamp receive our people in the salary grade one, stamps receive, we are bound by it. You are, you know, it's just getting to be really stupid. Yeah. Go get a good lawyer.
Because his argument is that his nomination, his candidacy, in effect, was accepted. The question is, ang COMELEC ba pag ganyan, you don't ask for birth certificates, no?
Ma'am, there's already a certificate. He says he's 34 years old. Why do we have to require them to? That's why we make them fill up that form. Because if they lie, they're going to go to jail.
Yeah.
Well, maybe he won't go to jail now. He'll go to jail after 5 years when he's older, much older, and bankrupt because I will sue him next year. Because my father's really upset that he says I asked for only 2 million.
Okay. No, but wait. So the interesting part is this, you can be charged after lying.
Yeah.
To COMELEC. Yes. Because that's the thing there is he thinks, look, the argument that he says is, look, we were accepted. If there was a problem from the beginning, dapat hindi kami tinanggap.
Well,
but what you're saying, that's his lookout because he was under.
Why do you have to worry about all of you? There are thousands of you filing, even the kabataan barangay. They all filed and they're overage pala. And then we find out later and we tell them, no, you are removed from office.
So will the COMELEC file a case against him as a body? Because it's not about you, that one.
The four of them.
Okay, so the COMELEC will, so that's one.
But I already endorsed it to the law department.
What happens if he's found guilty of that? Well, what's the penalty?
He goes to jail, but two times, because he submitted another list, right? That, again, he is not disqualified.
Uh-oh.
I will send you the form,
Yeah.
Because it is not private, it is notarized.
Yeah.
It can be shown to the public.
So it's
says, again, he is not disqualified. He submitted another list after he filed appeal. So, he has two counts of material misrepresentation. Yeah. Well, maybe the first one, he can go on probation. The second one, he has to go to jail.
Yeah. Now, he also wrote a letter to the chairman and said that this should be under the jurisdiction, it's in my notes, of the HRET.
Hmm? But we already resolved that.
Yeah.
In the first division, the ponente already answered that. This case is under our jurisdiction, not the HRET. Why? Mm-mm. Because we did not issue a certificate of nomination to him or to his party list. And the Secretary General should not accept his oath of office, which is baseless. That oath of office is a lot of crap. It's trash. Mm-mm. Anybody can just go to the notary public, sign an oath of office, have a picture taken, but did he sit as congressman? No, because the Secretary General didn't let him. Why not? Because he doesn't have a certificate of nomination, a certificate of proclamation from us, the COMELEC.
Uh-oh. Now, will you file a case against him in the sense that he is slandering your person?
No,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's libel.
Yeah, your reputation, claiming that you are corrupt. Okay, I'll read. He claims kakasuhan kanya ng extortion. Ang soundbite niya, isang saksak na lang, wala, patay na kami. He says, akala niya siya si Miriam Defensor Santiago. She approved the Duterte youth kasi may kapalit. Huh? So he believes that he must have gotten some information that you had already approved it in principle. But then when he could not deliver supposedly what you were asking for,
2 million.
You went against
the party.
No, but
he said in unang hirit that he gave 2 million. So which is it? That he could not give, that's why I voted against him? Or he gave 2 million and I still did not vote for him.
Okay.
If he gave 2 million and I still disqualified him, eh, he's stupid nga.
Oh, oh. The UK, you need to explain that because that one was said in GMA 7.
Yeah.
So he claims that he paid 2 million pesos to supposedly reach you.
Oh, that's what he said.
Through
and
who?
Still,
through
and
who?
Still he was disqualified.
Through who?
I don't know who. Mm. He said, first he says he attempted.
Yeah.
He did not. Give. Then, he gave. Oh, which is which ba talaga? Hey, let's open the bank book of this guy if he has 2 million, huh? And I'll open my bank book also. We'll do it here in Head Start.
Oh.
Let him bring his bank book and I will bring my sal in. Is it not? Show me. You don't even have 500,000 in your pocket right now and you dare say you bribe me with 2 million?
Yeah.
But by golly.
But then clearly that would be... I mean, you're just thinking of filing libel or you're thinking of filing
we'll
something?
File it next year because if I file it now, he has to inhibit me. Huh?
Mm-mm.
Ano ito, pautakan nito eh. This guy is trying to outsmart me. I was mayor already when he was 1 year old. I was already mayor of a Warlord City. Pautakan pa niya ako eh. Hindi pa nga siya marunong magsalawal ng mayor na ako. Huh? And he says he bribed me with 2 million. I was already being chauffeured in a Mercedes-Benz grade 1 in Cadiz West Elementary School. You bribed me with 2 million. You think that's enough for my family to believe you?
I think you're really insulted with 2 million.
Yeah, I'm insulted with this 2 million. My father's really angry.
It's with the 2 million you're insulted.
So we're going to file in Negros all these suits. So he has to fly there and travel through all these sugar cane fields for an hour before he reaches Cadiz. You'll sue him.
Okay, but what's interesting that you said that I caught is you believe that it is a strategic play.
Oh.
Essentially pushing you against the wall so you'll inhibit.
Akala niya I'll be scared of him? He should be the one who should be very scared.
Okay.
Because he doesn't have money, he doesn't have lawyers, and by golly, we're not gonna let up on this one.
Okay. Can the commission force you to inhibit? Under what circumstances?
No.
Between us, can just a commissioner, I mean, under what circumstances should a commissioner inhibit?
When Rodrigo Duterte ran, Mayor Duterte ran, I also said at the first instance that there is a case against him, so we should not yet accept his certificate of candidacy.
Okay.
I was also the one who said that. It's on record.
Mm-mm.
That's why his lawyer, Secretary Aguirre, my friend, inhibited me. Coco Pimentel was there in the hearing, sitting at the back. Why should I inhibit? Why? Who's scared of you? I did not inhibit. Mm-hmm. My whole division said there is no ground for inhibition, and we signed all of it.
Mm-hmm.
You think you attack one commissioner, you think we will not circle the wagons? Ah, you're stupid.
Mm-mm. And I think that was a much harder case.
And that's a much harder case.
That's a much harder case.
And then it was raffled to me. The president knows that. Raffled to me whether or not Rodrigo Duterte should be disqualified. I wrote that ponensya. I said, no, he cannot be disqualified.
Mm-mm.
Oh, I said, no, he cannot be. He's not disqualified. Again, our decision was unanimous in the first division. When the president, I saw the president in a mascara in Bacolod, and I introduced myself. I said, Mr. President, Commissioner Rowena Guanzon. He said, kilala kita, ma'am. Tigas ba? Tigas.
Mm-hmm.
So, I was mayor when Mayor Duterte was mayor of Davao. I was mayor of Cadiz. That's how we first met in the League of Cities.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya wag niya ako. Don't tell him the president will side with him in this fight against me. Ah. And the president knows he's lying.
So then Cardema did tell Christian. Christian asked, but why would someone like Commissioner Guanzon, in other words, need you? And he said, kasi si Commissioner Guanzon was appointed by the other administration and ako, I may not be able to go straight to the president, but pwede ako lumapit sa malapit kay presidente.
Allah, I can call the executive secretary for the to endorse these appointments for judges.
Mm-mm.
We were in Accra together. We were young lawyers together.
Mm-mm.
We know each other by nicknames. But of course, I didn't do that. Well, why will I call him? Who is he? He's nothing. But if I really want my sister appointed, I will go to the president, is it not? Or the executive secretary.
Mm-hmm.
But we are not applying for any position because We're already.
Yeah.
I mean, my whole family, we're already at the top of our game. Doctors, lawyers, mm-hmm. judges, mm-hmm. sugar farmers, politicians, we're at the top of our game. We have honored the Filipino people. We have honored our ancestors by serving with integrity and competence. So now, he says, I bribed him for $2 million. Ah, my father is really upset. Mm-hmm. So now, we're gonna bankrupt him. Okay, we're gonna sue him until he's really bankrupt.
Okay, thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.